It was the 10th of September, 1952, a rainy tropical day, during the midst of the Korean War. Captain Jesse Fulmer, a distinguished ace pilot, was in his Corsair F4U 4B, part of squadron VMFA 312. His wingman for this dangerous ground attack mission was Lieutenant Daniels. Their weapons loadout mainly consisted of two 1,000-pound bombs and 8 HVAR rockets, a heavy loadout. Their takeoff at 1610 hours of the light aircraft carrier, USS Sicily. Their target was to attack a concentration of tanks near the south side of the Taedong River, close to Sinampo, North Korea. By 1700 hours, Captain Fulmer and his wingman was now 10,000 feet away, just as they passed over the coast, and were headed straight into enemy territory. Fulmer recalls that there was no enemy activity within the area and continues to fly around the Taedong estuary on reconnaissance. It was now just past 1800 hours. They banked past a small island, and suddenly Captain Fulmer spots something approaching behind him, very low and fast. At first he struggled to identify what it was. It was silver in color and something he had never seen in flight before. However, as several seconds go by, it was soon evident what this mysterious flying object was. He couldn't believe his eyes. It was two MiG-15 Russian fighter jets in loose formation, rapidly approaching his Corsair for an attack run. Whilst the Corsair was one of the best planes that took to the air during World War II, it was heavily outclassed and outgunned by the modern MiG-15 fighter jet, one that could almost reach supersonic speeds in a dive and carried two 23mm and one 37mm cannon in the nose. A single shot from one of these guns would tear a World War II propeller plane apart. In comparison, the F4U 4B armed four 20mm cannons and could reach speeds of up to 446 miles per hour. Whilst old, the four 20mm cannons were still extremely deadly. Captain Fulmer was an experienced pilot. He knew that this was a fight he couldn't run from. Immediately, he drops his entire ordnance along with his drop tanks. With the two 1,000-pound bombs and 8 rockets off the wing, his plane became much lighter and more responsive. The Corsair was fitted with a Pratt & Whitney R2800, an 18-cylinder behemoth of an engine. Fulmer had toggled war emergency power. His engine rumbles as it pushes 3,400 horsepower into the Corsair's massive triple-blade propeller. He informs Lieutenant Daniels to keep together in an aggressive defensive weave pattern till the MiGs got close. He knew that the jets were going far too quick to turn fight their old Corsairs. Skillfully, he informs Daniels to break right, whilst he broke left. The MiGs thunder by through the middle, unable to keep up with their turns, and pull vertical for another run. Fulmer had planned to turn in and fire a burst of 20mm as it flew on the inside. The cannons on the Corsair could certainly take them out, but targeting such a fast-moving object in such a short amount of time was extremely difficult. He recalls the MiGs diving back down on them, and he sees the tracers fly by his cockpit. The MiGs had much more advanced weaponry and could target us from further away. He decides on doing a slight corkscrew maneuver. Doing this would prevent the MiGs from turning their guns onto his tail, as they were going too quick for his turns. He plans to put the 20mm burst in front of them just as they pass below. The first MiG falls into his trap. He gives the MiG a 20mm lead and opens up his four cannons. He holds it down for a good 5 seconds, doing his absolute best to lead. Astonishingly, he hits the MiG-15 square in the fuselage as he sees bright flashes from his AP tracer rounds. The MiG's engine had been set on fire. A thick grey smoke trail begins to come out of the jet as it dives down. The MiG pilot gives up and ejects. Captain Fulmer could see his G-suit ablaze as he flies by the parachute, looking directly at the pilot. Captain Fulmer recalls, "I had nothing personal against the MiG pilot. We were just doing our jobs." As he sees the MiG-15 pilot burning up helplessly in his G-suit, He immediately flies in front of the parachute, attempting to put out the fire using his powerful prop blast. He saves the enemy pilot. The flaming MiG smashes vertically into the Taedong estuary. Fulmer and Daniels resume their defensive weave pattern. Both knew that this was just the start of the fight. They had no assistance other than themselves, and they had spent a good amount of ammo taking out that one MiG. They see another four MiG-15s rapidly approaching them in two loose columns. Fulmer knew that they were unlikely to make it out of this one. The least he could do was try and save his dear friend, Wingman Lieutenant Daniels. He tells him to break for home immediately, and that he would try to fight the MiGs as best as he could to buy time. If Daniels could near USS Sicily, the 36 40mm AA guns fitted on the carrier would make easy work of the MiGs. Lieutenant Daniels wishes Captain Fulmer the best and splits off for home. Still with war emergency power, Fulmer puts his plane into a steep dive as it shudders with overspeed. He was pushing the old fighter like never before. His airspeed indicator couldn't measure his actual speed as it was off the dial. It's estimated that he neared 550 miles per hour in his Corsair. Suddenly, Fulmer hears an explosion and feels a jolt. The second MiG had hit its 37mm cannon round. He turns around and sees roughly 5 feet of his port side wing missing and his starboard horizontal stabilizer shot clean off. The 20mm cannons of his Corsair were hanging freely below by their ammo belts. Amazingly, the Corsair was still flying after being hit by such a large caliber round. He puts his control column into the full right position to even out the missing wing and tail sections. He pulls up the crippled Corsair with every last bit of his strength for one last attempt before his inevitable end. With only two 20mm cannons left on his starboard wing, he fires the last of his 100 rounds at an oncoming MiG-15. He damages the MiG by the wing, but the jet does not go down. But with such a large amount of damage, his engine overheating on more emergency power, and his weaponry disabled, he was unlikely to survive much longer. Hoping that he had bought enough time for his wingman to get far enough, there was nothing more that he could do in his crippled Corsair. Captain Fulmer readies to transmit his search and rescue position to the USS Sicily and bail out. Just as he prepares to bail, a third MiG-15 would open fire behind him. He could hear the thunder of those heavy Russian cannons as the shells passed by his plane. Luckily, they were wide and narrowly missed his Corsair. He successfully bails out and hides in the brushes by the river. His beloved Corsair that he had flown for the last half a decade had been destroyed. This is when he sees that there was in fact 8 MiG-15s in the sky, not 4. He watches as the MiGs patrol for an hour and leave the area to refuel. His wingman Daniels had landed on USS Sicily and helped with the search and rescue effort, not knowing whether or not his captain would still be alive when he got there. An SA-16 Albatross was able to locate Captain Fulmer using a search and rescue transmission. He had gone up against 8 MiG-15 fighter jets in his propeller warplane, first designed in the 1940s, and even managed to take one down with him. Something that nobody could have ever expected, nor what the plane was designed for. Fulmer would become the first piston engine pilot to shoot down a MiG in air-to-air combat. By his indomitable courage, outstanding airmanship, and gallant devotion to duty by sacrificing his own life to save his fellow airmen, he was awarded the Silver Star, the Distinguished Flying Cross, and the prestigious Purple Heart. During his later years, he would be honored by the National Museum of Aviation History in Pensacola, Florida, where you can see his painting of this MiG encounter. He would also be inducted into the Alabama Aviation Hall of Fame and would pass away on the 30th of July 2004, aged 84. Please help us in keeping these long-lost memories alive by subscribing to our channel and supporting us on Patreon. Thank you for watching. Stay safe.